Report!
Main power's offline. We've lost shields. Our weapons are gone.
Perhaps today is a good day to die.
The well-known Klingon expression, "Perhaps today is a good day to die," highlights the invented images created for this invented warrior class by the writers and the producers of the Star Trek series. But how does this relate to samurai? This phrase mirrors the Western understanding of the invented samurai concept of Bushido, where honor is found in death on the battlefield, preferably by the sword. Klingons have a similar concept in their use of the weapon, the batleth.
What I say now, I say as a member of the House of Martok, not a Starfleet officer. You have dishonored yourself and the Empire, and you are not worthy to lead the Council.
There can be only one answer to that.
Worf, this is madness.
The Empire.
War. The text Hagakure is used by Yukio Mishima, stating that one who is a samurai must before all things keep constantly in mind the fact he has to die. This statement applies to Klingon culture and ideology, showing a Western interpretation of Bushido. In the previous clip, we saw Worf selecting a batleth, the Star Trek equivalent of a sword. For samurai, the soul of the warrior is his weapon. In his essay Bushido, the Soul of Japan, Nitobe Inazo states that the sword was his weapon of choice. Klingons are no different, and as representations of samurai, they too opt for a sword during battle.
Baseball. We will destroy them.
Find him and kill him!
Death to the opposition!
The baseball scene in the previous clip shows Worf's loyalty to his captain, taking every opportunity, even a baseball game, to show his allegiance. Although samurai may not find themselves on the diamond, the ideal samurai was loyal until death to one master, whose service he was always willing to sacrifice his life without a moment's hesitation. Worf, a Klingon, is a modern-day interpretation of samurai because of his steadfast loyalty, despite the fact that his character is based off of the invented traditions of samurai from the Tokugawa period.
Look. I'm just not sure that I should be giving you advice on what to do in this situation. It's a Klingon matter.
You are still a member of the House of Martok.
This is the first that I've heard of it.
The General and I talked about it weeks ago. He likes you, and he considers you an honorable woman, a worthy successor to Jadzia. And so do I.
It's very sweet of him.
Sweet?
Not a very Klingon word, is it?
No.
It's very honorable.
Better, albeit a little obvious. Tell me what you think.
Okay. But I'm not sure you're going to like it.
Tell me.
I think that this situation with Gowron is a symptom of a bigger problem. The Klingon Empire is dying. And I think it deserves to die.
You are right. I do not like it.
Don't get me wrong. I'm very touched that you still consider me to be a member of the House of Martok. But I tend to look at the Empire with a little more skepticism than Curzon or Jadzia did. I see a society that is in deep denial about itself. We're talking about a warrior culture that prides itself on maintaining centuries-old traditions of honor and integrity. But in reality, it's willing to accept corruption at the highest levels.
You are overstating your case.
Am I? Who was the last leader of the High Council that you respected? Has there even been one? And how many times have you had to cover up the crimes of Klingon leaders because you were told that it was for the good of the Empire? I know this sounds harsh, but the truth is, you have been willing to accept a government that you know is corrupt. Gowron is just the latest example.
Worf,
you are the most honorable and decent man that I've ever met. And if you are willing to tolerate men like Gowron, then what hope is there for the Empire?
The discussion of the Klingon Empire as being corrupt and unstable is a direct link to the crumbling foundation of the political system of the Tokugawa period. A quote from Masui's story, "I feared no one. Appearances had to be kept up. My foolishness was dragging me further into debt." The fall of the Klingon Empire mirrors the end of the samurai as political rulers in Japan.
One ship against 10 doesn't seem possible.
He will succeed. He is Kor, the Daha Master.
He's done it. The Jem'Hadar are out of time. They can no longer overtake us before we reach the Defiant.
How did that pompous old man hold off an entire Jem'Hadar fleet with only one ship?
Does it matter?
Darak, give me that bottle. To Kor, the Dahar Master, a noble warrior to the end.
Mikokara. Endo kila
Pedo chum karedo pila
Stampa ripto Mala eko Glika
here seen honoring an old warrior's actions through the tradition of drink and song. Tradition here serves as a way of allowing everyone to partake in the celebrations and legitimizes his actions. These traditions are inventions by the writers and producers of the Star Trek series but mirror the West's interpretation of the Samurai Code of Bushido, the way of the warrior of the Samurai Code of Chivalry. Invented tradition is taken to mean a set of practices normally governed by overtly or tactically accepted rules and of a ritual or symbolic nature, which seek to inculcate certain values and norms of behavior by repetition, which automatically implies continuity with the past. In fact, where possible, they normally attempt to establish continuity with a suitable historical past. Are indeed a representation of samurai and highlights how the West interprets invented samurai traditions such as Bushido, believing in the cultural creation established by samurai during the Tokugawa period. It is difficult to say if the writers and the producers of the Star Trek series understood that many concepts that the West has about samurai is invented tradition to serve a certain political ideology of the Tokugawa period. It is reasonable to suggest that Klingons are based off of samurai classes, highlighting the West's perception of samurai and their code of behavior, Bushido.